So we are at Lake Rotomahana, and it's in the Rotorua area. It's quite a volcanically active area. The big volcano that you see in the background here, or mountain, is Mount Tarawera. It erupted in 1886, and it was a devastating eruption. It totally changed the lake. The lake became much bigger, and the fissure from the big mountain, from Mount Tarawera, runs right down the center of this lake, and it is still active today. There's a lot of geothermal activity that we can see on land up the Waimangu Valley here, but also underneath the lake. And so we are here today as part of a survey to look at the amount of heat that's coming out of the bottom of the lake here. And so we're using this new technique. We have these blankets, they're thermal blankets. On the top we have the thermometer or thermistor, and this measures the temperature. And then we have a second one on the bottom that measures the temperature on the bottom of the blanket. The bottom of the blanket is located right on the mud or on the rock on the bottom of the lake. The top of the blanket is recording the temperature of the water at the bottom of the lake. And what we're interested in is the temperature difference between those two. That temperature difference tells us about how much heat is coming out of the bottom of the lake, and that's what we call heat flow. So we have 10 of these blankets that we have been deploying across the lake, and the idea is to distribute these in about 100 different locations, sample stations, to measure the heat flow across the entire bottom of the lake. Well, this is the first time we've ever used these blankets in a lake environment. The density of measurements that we've made in this lake have never been done before. So to deploy these blankets, we lower them over the side of the boat. We get rid of the air bubbles. Then we start lowering the blanket very slowly down to the bottom. It's about 100 meters down, so it takes about 5 minutes for us to lower this thing slowly by hand to the bottom of the lake. And once it hits the bottom of the lake, the line goes slack. We then put a little float on the top, and then we let it go. We leave the blankets on the bottom of the lake for about 24 hours, and so the following day we basically pull the blanket up again, pull it by hand or by a winch onto the boat, and then once it's on the boat we then drive over to another sample station and redeploy it to take the next reading on the bottom of the lake. This is a recording from one of the thermal blankets for the first four stations that we did. On this axis here you can see the temperature, and the range is about 3 degrees from top to bottom. So each one of these is a day-long recording of the thermal blanket. The curves that you see, the top curve here, is the curve on the bottom of the blanket when it sits on the bottom of the lake, and how the thermistor comes to settle down to the temperature of the mud. Then the bottom trace here is the temperature of the bottom of the lake water. So, and that is the thermistor that's sitting on top of the blanket. And the essential measurement that we have is once this has come settled down, we see the difference between these two measurements, and that is a measure of what the heat flux is coming out of the bottom. So on the first three stations that you see, the blanket is cooling off and we see a little bit of heat flow coming out from these. These are actually fairly significant heat flows. This one on the end is a very strong heat flow. It's got an almost 1.5 degree difference, and that compares to approximately 30 watts per square meter, which is very high for a heat flow measurement. Okay, so here is a map of the deployment stations on the lake, and you see about 100 thermal blanket stations here. There's a very strong high over here, very strong heat flow in here and in here, and these are very high, more than 50 watts per meter squared, which is amazing really. In fact, we've got more recent measurements that now show so almost 90 watts coming out of the bottom. In my career as a scientist studying heat flow, I really have not seen anything this strong. This is an incredible amount of heat coming out of the bottom of the lake.